1 o'clock, and we come now to a recital given by the guitarist Julian Bream on the 5th of May 1975 as part of a series of lunchtime concerts from St. John's, Smith Square. The announcer was Patricia Hughes.
Welcome again to St. John's, Smith Square, London, and to our Radio 3 lunchtime concert. Today, we are delighted to have Julian Bream with us, and he's going to give a guitar recital of works by Weiss, Bach, Searle, Faglia, and Arnold. He begins with three pieces composed for the lute by Silvius Leopold Weiss, who came from a family of musicians. He was born a year later than Bach, whom he's known to have visited at Leipzig in 1739. Apart from his great skill as a composer, Weiss was praised by his German contemporaries for his matchless skill as a performer. Mathieson called him the greatest lutenist in the world. Forkel said of his compositions that they were comparable with the clavier works of Bach himself. The music is in a style readily recognizable as belonging to the world of Bach's instrumental music. The three pieces by Weiss, with which Julian Bream begins his recital, are Passacaille in D major, Tombeau sur la mort de Monsieur Comte de Logis, and Fantasy. So now let's give a very warm welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Julian Bream.
Thank you. Thank you.
After those three pieces by Sylvius Leopold Weiss, Julian Bream continues his recital with his own transcription for guitar of the suite in E minor, BWV 996, by Bach. Although several manuscript versions of the suite exist in keyboard notation, it was almost certainly written originally for lute. As Julian Bream says, the richly sonorous tessitura and the bold figurations so characteristic of the lute are also admirably suited to the guitar. It was these factors, together with the beauty and the power of the work, that led him to make this transcription. There are seven movements. The first is a prelude leading to a fugato. Then follows an allemande, a courante, a sarabande, a bourrée, and a finale in 12/8 time. Here it is then, the suite in E minor by Bach. Thank you.
Thank you.
Julian Bream played his own transcription of the suite in E minor by Bach. He's going to play next a work specially written for him by Humphrey Searle. It's called Five and was given its first concert performance in the Queen Elizabeth Hall in January this year. Today it's receiving its first broadcast performance. The title means simply that it's in five sections to be played without break. They are Prelude, Allegro, Lento, Scherzo, and Postlude. Julian Bream gave that first broadcast performance of Five, Opus 61, which was written specially for him by Humphrey Searle. And we're delighted to have him with us here in St. John's today. He's just come up to the platform to acknowledge that applause. And now Julian Bream continues his lunchtime recital in St. John's with two pieces by Faglia. The first is in memory of Debussy, whom Fallier had come to know well during his stay in Paris from 1907 to 1914. The music dates from 1921 and was a contribution to an obituary number of the French magazine Revue Musicale, which was brought out after Debussy's death in 1918. It's the only work Manuel de Fallier has written for the guitar. The other piece by Fallier, which we're going to hear, is The Miller's Dance from the ballet The Three-Cornered Hat in Julian Bream's own arrangement. Thank you. Julian Bream played those two pieces by Faglia, homage to Debussy, and his own arrangement of The Miller's Dance from the ballet The Three-Cornered Hat. His recital ends with a work by Malcolm Arnold, Fantasy, Opus 107, which is another work dedicated to Julian Bream. In fact, this fantasy is the most recent work Malcolm Arnold has dedicated to him. It's in seven movements: prelude, scherzo, arietta, fughetta, another arietta, march, and postlude.
Thank you.
Malcolm Arnold's Fantasy, Opus 107, which ends this recital given by Julian Bream. It was first broadcast in May 1975.